Right now we have this gallery, as we can see in the screen, and we can highlight the selected item as we learned in the previous class. Now I'm going to show some configurations that are very important and very interesting for galleries in order to let the user know that the gallery is interactive. If I exit the play mode and select this gallery that's showing the contacts, we can see the gallery's properties pane here in the right. Okay, if I scroll down, I have some configurations here for the gallery, and the first one we are gonna see is the transition. Right now, the transition is set to known, but I have two different transitions here, the pop and the push. Let's select, for example, the pop and see what happens when we play the app. I'm going to play the app, and now I will hover my mouse over the gallery items. So we can see that they pop from the gallery, giving this idea of a selectable element. And that itself adds a lot of interactivity to the user. And now the user knows that it's possible to click in the gallery. The other transition that we have is the push. So let's select the gallery again and go to the transition property, changing to push. Okay, now I'm gonna hit play again. And we can see that the items now are pushed in the gallery once I hover my mouse on it. And if I click, of course, the background of the item will highlight. Okay, that was the tip for this class, but let's see two other important concepts here that we can configure very quickly. Again, selecting the gallery, we can see that we have the show scroll bar property and the show navigation. Right now the show scroll bar is active, so we see this scroll bar in the sides, in the right side of the gallery. If I disable it, it will disappear, but if I still play the app and I use my mouse wheel, I can see that the gallery has more items. But I would recommend to keep it enabled so the user see that it's possible to scroll the gallery. But there is another option. If you don't want the scroll bar, you can select the gallery and then enable the show navigation property. So once we click on enable, we set to true, and we play the app, we can see this navigation button here in the bottom of the gallery. And if we click, it will scroll the gallery items. And then the navigation button will also appear in the top if we have more items in the top of the gallery. Right now, this button is not very configurable in the sense that we cannot change its design, so it will always look like this. Okay, so I will select the gallery, disable the show navigation, and keep the scroll bar with the transition set to push. Now we can see that if we play, we have the scroll bar back and the push transition showing that the items are clickable. So the users understand that they can interact with the gallery. Given that, see you in the next video.